FarmChem's ChemMATE Junior Auto Batching Pump System is an automatic chemical dispensing system that allows you to easily batch quantities. The ChemMATE Junior is a pump that is designed for repeatable batching. It has a mounted flow meter that will automatically turn off when it pumps the amount you enter. The kit comes with a 1-inch by 5-foot suction hose, a 1-inch by 12-foot discharge hose, two 90-degree hose barbs, two hose clamps, a 90-degree elbow, a coupler, a bushing, a 2-inch cam lock, and a ball valve nozzle. Before assembling, make sure all threaded parts have sealant tape to prevent leaks. First, mount the ChemMATE Junior onto the cage tank and secure it in place. Insert hose barbs into both ends of the suction hose, then screw in the coupler onto one end. Screw the bushing and then the cam lock onto the other end. Screw the coupler into the suction port of the pump and lock the cam lock onto the cam lock of the tank. Next, thread the 90-degree elbow to the discharge port. Follow this by threading the hose into the elbow, then threading on the nozzle. Hook the clips to the power source, and physical assembly is complete. Now it's time to calibrate the meter. Please note that there are three calibration options, so we will walk you through all of them. Also, if you get an error on the display, assume that no calibration has taken place and restart the process on the setting you are currently on. Cal 1 requires pumping 5 units of fluid. Cal 2 requires the pumping of a known quantity of any units. This quantity is then entered into the electronics. And Cal 3 allows calibration without pumping fluid by manually changing the calibration constant. Before performing meter calibration, turn the pump on by pressing the toggle switch to the on manual position. Purge the pump and hose of all air. For best results, calibrate at normal dispensing conditions. Always calibrate with the product being measured. Calibrating the Cal 1 button. Step 1. Press the on button to wake up the meter. Step 2. Press and hold the reset button to zero the current total screen. Step 3. Press Cal 1 to enter the calibration sequence. Step 4. Pump liquid into the calibrated container that holds 5 units. Please note that the display will blink as fluid is being pumped. Step 5. Press Cal 1 to complete the calibration process. Please note that the display will return to the current total screen and should read 0. Calibrating the Cal 2 button. Step 1. Press the on button to wake up the meter. Step 2. Press and hold the reset button to zero the current total screen. Step 3. Press Cal 1 to enter calibration mode. Step 4. Press Cal 2 to enter calibration Cal 2 mode. Step 5. Dispense the desired amount. For greatest accuracy, pump a minimum of 2.5 gallons or 9.5 liters. The minimum amount required is 0.5 gallons or 1.9 liters. Step 6. Press Cal 1. The last volume entered will appear on the display. Example, if you previously calibrated 30 quarts, then 30.00 would appear. First time default is 5.00. Step 7. Press the up or down arrow keys to scroll on the amount actually pumped. Use the desired units. For example, if you pump 2 gallons but you want the meter to display quarts, enter 8.00. Step 8. Press Cal 1 to enter the amount and finish the calibration process. The display will return to the current total screen and should read 0. Calibrating the Cal 3 button. Step 1. Press Cal 1 to enter calibration mode. Step 2. Press Cal 3. The current Cal 3 number will show. A typical Cal 3 number for water is around 600. Step 3. Press the up or down arrow keys to scroll to the desired Cal 3 number. Step 4. Press Cal 1 to enter the new number. This calibration procedure can also be completed using a legal for trade scale in place of the proven container. You will need to know the weight of the product per gallon to calculate the total weight to be caught. Always check your meter calibration against a prover or a calibrated scale prior to using for the day. To use the batching feature, start with the toggle switch in the off auto position. Hit the Cal 1 button, then hit on to make the screen say Cal 4. Use the up and down arrows to decide on how much you want to pump. then hit Cal 1 once again when you hit the amount you want. Hit On and the Cal 3 button at the same time to start the batch. You can hit the Cal 2 button to pause the pump during the batch, and hit On and Cal 3 again to resume it. As an FYI, the pump shuts off at the amount you enter, so there may be a little fluid pumped out as it shuts off. For more information on the ChemMATE Junior, call us at 800-247-1854 or visit shop.farmchem.com.